Now let's discuss some more concepts. Till now we have discussed the concepts of opening entry, bad debts recovered, outstanding expenses. Now come to the next, that is prepaid expenses. Now, prepaid expenses means expenses of the next year which have been paid in the current year. Fine? Next year's expenses paid in the current year, such expenses are known as prepaid expenses. See, this thing we have already discussed, that prepaid expenses are our assets. You know this thing very well. Fine? That prepaid expenses are our assets. So all the assets are having debit balances. It means we should debit prepaid expenses account. Correct? And now these expenses are related to next year. No? Like read the statement. Out of rent paid this year. Means aapne jitna bhi rent is year mein pay kiya hai. 10,000 is related to next year. Us mein se 10,000 next year ka. So it means 10,000 is prepaid. So we need to pass the entry prepaid expenses account debited to expense account. Now here, what is the expense? Here expenses, rent. So replace the word expense by rent. Prepaid rent account debited to rent account and amount is 10,000. So this is the entry. See students, few entries are such whose concepts will be clear to you, but with the passage of time. You can't assume this thing that everything will be clear to you today only. So these are such entries which will be clear to you in the later chapters. Fine. So just read, learn or understand these entries like this only. If such entries comes that out of the rent paid this year, 10,000 is related to next year. It means that this is the entry for prepaid and entry is prepaid rent account debited to rent account. Had it been like insurance in place of rent, you would have passed the entry prepaid insurance to insurance. Had it been interest, you would have passed the entry prepaid interest to interest. Now, prepaid expenses are also known as unexpired expenses. Please make a note. Prepaid expenses are also known as unexpired expenses. So, if in the question it is written that unexpired insurance is so and so rupees, it means that like in the question they are talking about prepaid insurance. I hope this concept is clear to you. Now move to one more concept which you have already discussed a number of times. This concept is again not new for you. You have discussed this concept lot many times. You know that business and businessman, they both are separate. Business is a natural person. Sorry, business is an artificial person. Businessman is a natural person. They both are different from each other. Now the money invested by the businessman in the business is known as capital. That you know very well, no? And capital is a liability also. And reason you know also, because when the business gets wind up, we have to return this capital to the owner. But when business will wind up, that time period we don't know. So till that time period, means from the starting to the ending of the business, till that time period, the business has to pay some interest to the businessman. I repeat what I said. Amount invested by the businessman is known as capital. He is the owner. Got it? And this capital is a liability because the business has to repay this money to the businessman when business gets closed. But when business will get closed, that time period we don't know. So till that period, the business will pay some interest to the businessman. Now you know that we are maintaining here accounts books of business. So now if business is paying some interest on the capital, so this interest on capital will become an expense for the business and all the expenses are debited. We are paying interest on which amount? We are paying interest on capital. So we need to credit here capital. Entry becomes interest on capital to capital. Now capital is 2 lakh. Interest is 10%. So interest becomes 20,000. I hope this thing is clear. Now again move to the same concept. Business and businessman, they are two different entities. If businessman takes money from the business for personal use, this money is known as drawings. Drawings have been done by businessman. From where? From the business. So businessman has to pay interest on this amount, this drawing to business. Because जिसने पैसा withdraw किया है वो person ही interest pay करेगा. In this case the money has been taken by businessman, so interest will be paid by businessman to the business. Now out of these two we are maintaining accounts books of business, and business is getting the interest in return. Fine. So this interest becomes an income for the business. So what entry are you going to pass here? So you are going to pass the entry drawings account debited to interest on drawings. Drawings account debited to interest on drawings 15,000. So these are the like important entries. You need to understand them the way only I have explained you. The logic will be more clearer to you and will be stored in your mind the moment you'll do the further chapters. Thank you. First is goods given away as charity or free samples. See, at times what a businessman do? A businessman gives the goods in the form of charity to outside people. Fine. So it becomes an expense for the business. Because when we are giving goods in the form of charity, it means that we are incurring some expense and we are not getting cash in return for the same. It means that charity becomes an expense for the business. Same way, sometimes the business gives the goods in the form of free samples also. You might have seen that sometimes some salesman comes to your place and they say, please try our product and if you like it, please buy it. So it means that they are giving you the goods in the form of free samples and they are not charging anything for you that time. So it means this free samples is also an expense for the business. So charity and free samples, these both things are the expense of the business. And why are we giving the goods as free samples? Just to enhance the sales. So in both the cases, charity and in case of free samples, we need to debit these accounts. Because charity and free samples both are expense for the business. So pass the entry. Free samples, or if you give the goods away as charity, both are an expense, no? Because we are not getting the money in return and we are giving the goods of the business. And goods means the things in which the business deals. So what goes out of the business in this case? Goods goes out. But in place of goods, we have to use the word purchase. So what is the entry? Free samples to purchases or charity account debited to purchase account. Third case is when drawings and goods. Drawings means when the owner of the business, he takes some money from the business for its personal use. You know this thing very well. Now a businessman can take cash from the business also for personal use. A businessman can take money from the bank account of the company also for personal use, and a businessman may withdraw some goods from the business also for personal use. You have already done the first two cases. When the businessman withdraws like cash from the business for personal use, the journal entry is drawings account debited to cash account. When the owner is withdrawing some cash from the bank for its personal use, then you pass the entry drawings account debited to bank account. But in this case, what a businessman is doing? A businessman is taking goods from the business for its personal use. So what entry you are going to pass in this case? Entry will be drawings account debited to. Now here also, just like free samples in charity, goods are going out of the business in this case also. But in this case, the goods has been taken by the proprietor or the owner for its personal use, yet the goods are going out of the business. So you will write the word purchases in place of goods. I hope this point is also clear to you. Now come to the last concept. At times what happens that goods, they may get destroyed by fire. or the goods can also be, you know, lost, or the like there is some loss which we can, like which a business has to incur in the form of theft also, or due to some fire also. So in that case, generally what happens, let me put it formally in this way, that it is the wish of the business that whether to get the, like whether to get their goods insured or not. Insured means to get their insurance policy or not. Fine, like we get our insurance of car, we get the insurance of our house, we get even our life insurance. Same way, at times the business also gets the goods insured against fire or against theft. Ki agar kabhi aag lag jaye ya goods chori ho jaye, then we can get the claim from the insurance company. Now there are two instances, whether the goods are whether the goods which are destroyed, they are insured, or the goods which are destroyed, they are not insured. These are two different cases. So let us start with the first case, when there is no claim. No claim means you haven't got the goods insured. And second case is when, in case of claim means when you have got the goods insured. Fine. So let us discuss first part, when there is some insurance policy. Fine. So first of all, let's say entry. If the goods have been destroyed by loss, the goods have been destroyed by fire or theft, then you have to debit this thing, because you know all the losses are having debit balances. Now as goods have been destroyed, so in place of goods you have to write the word purchases. So purchase account is credit. In this case, the goods are going out of the business in the form of drawings, free samples or charity. That's why we have credited here purchase account. But in this case, the goods are not going anywhere out, but they have been destroyed. Now they are not in a position that we can sell them in the market and we can get some money. Simply they are destroyed. It means the value of the goods have been decreased. Goods are having debit balances. If their value has been decreased, so we need to credit them. So entry is loss by fire account debited to purchase account. Let's say the total value of goods which are destroyed is rupees 10,000. Now what will be the next step? Now your goods have been destroyed. Now what will you do? You will you will inform the insurance company. You will tell them that a fire occurred in our godown and goods of rupees 10,000 have been destroyed. So kindly come and help us. It means you are going to inform them, no? So the entry for informing the insurance company will be, insurance company account will be debited. Fine. And loss by theft or loss by fire account will be credited. This entry signifies that you have shifted this balance of, or shifted this burden of loss onto the shoulders of insurance company. You said this thing ki ab aap please hame ye loss recover kar dijiye. Basically you have shifted the burden of this loss onto the shoulders of insurance company. Ab aapne to apna loss unko de diya, that's why aapka loss to khatam ho jata hai. Means aap assume karte hain ki aapka loss khatam ho gaya. Now there is no loss in your books of accounts, so aapne kya kiya, loss ko credit kar diya. बिकॉज आप ये मान के चलते हैं कि आपका जितना लॉस हुआ है इंश्योरेंस कंपनी आपको उतना ही क्लेम दे देगी. बट जनरली डजंट हैपन. व्हेन इंश्योरेंस कंपनी कम्स टू योर बिजनेस, दे इंक्वायर दैट व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्चुअल लॉस. इफ दे फील दैट द वैल्यू रिपोर्टेड बाय यू इज मोर एंड द एक्चुअल लॉस इज लेस, सो इन दैट केस दे गिव्स यू लेसर मनी. Suppose insurance company feels that instead of loss of rupees 10,000, there is loss of only rupees 7,000. So they'll be giving only rupees 7,000 to you. Rest 3,000 will be your loss that you have to bear. So what entry would you pass for the same? Insurance company has given you cash of rupees 7,000 only. So 7,000 will come into the business. 3,000 loss now you have to bear. So that will be transferred to a new account which is known as profit and loss account. Two, who has given you this cash? Insurance company. 10,000. So you can see that total of debit is equal to total of credit. Please try and understand these three entries. See, I can give you one more like the way of understanding it. Assume yourself that you have a godown and goods of rupees 10,000 have been destroyed in your godown. So you have passed the entry as all the losses are debited. So you have passed the entry loss by debit, loss by fire account debited 10,000 to purchases 10,000. And why we have credited purchase accounts? Because the balance of goods have been reduced and to reduce debit we have to credit it. डेबिट को कम करने के लिए क्रेडिट करते हैं. गुड्स डिस्ट्रॉयड हुए, गुड्स का बैलेंस डेबिट होता है, तो जब डिस्ट्रॉय हो गए तो गुड्स कम हो गए, सो वी हैव टू क्रेडिट. देन वी इन्फॉर्म द इंश्योरेंस कंपनी दैट गुड्स ऑफ रुपीज 10,000 हैव बीन डिस्ट्रॉयड इन आवर बिजनेस, काइंडली हेल्प. आपने तो ये अज्यूम किया कि जितना लॉस आप बोलेंगे इंश्योरेंस कंपनी आपको उतना ही लॉस दे देगी, तो आपने 10,000 रुपीज जो लॉस डेबिट किया था नेक्स्ट एंट्री में आपने उस लॉस को क्रेडिट किया. मीन्स आपने अपनी बुक्स में तो से तो सारा लॉस निकाल दिया ये सोचकर कि इंश्योरेंस कंपनी विल गोइंग टू पे अस रुपीज कंप्लीट 10,000. नाउ दिस लॉस इज देयर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी, दिस लॉस इज नॉट आवर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. तो अब डेबिट को कम करने के लिए क्रेडिट करते हैं एज वी डिस्कस्ड. सो लॉसेज आर डेबिटेड, सो टू रिड्यूस देयर बैलेंस वी नीड टू क्रेडिट देम. 10,000 डेबिट था, 10,000 क्रेडिट किया, मीन्स आपने ये मान लिया कि लॉस बाय फायर से आपको कोई लॉस हुआ ही नहीं, जीरो रुपीज, बिकॉज यू बिलीव दैट इंश्योरेंस कंपनी इज गोइंग टू पे यू कंप्लीट रुपीज 10,000. नाउ इन दिस एंट्री द इंश्योरेंस कंपनी हैज ओनली पेड रुपीज 7,000 टू यू, बिकॉज व्हेन दे चेक्ड दे फील दैट देयर इज नो लॉस ऑफ 10,000, देयर इज ओनली लॉस ऑफ रुपीज 7,000. देन दे आर गोइंग टू गिव यू ओनली दैट मच मनी विच दे फील दैट दिस इज द अमाउंट ऑफ एक्चुअल लॉस. फाइन, सो दे हैव गिवन रुपीज 7,000 टू यू. सो डेबिट व्हाट कम्स इन एंड 3,000 यू आर गोइंग टू ट्रांसफर टू प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट. दिस इज अ न्यू अकाउंट दैट विल डू इन द लेटर चैप्टर. सो यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस एंट्री लाइक दिस ओनली, लर्न इट. एंड देन इंश्योरेंस कंपनी इज द गिवर, सो गिवर इट लाइक इज हैविंग द क्रेडिट बैलेंस, बिकॉज इंश्योरेंस कंपनी इज एन आर्टिफिशियल पर्सनल अकाउंट. सो द रूल डेबिट द रिसीवर क्रेडिट द गिवर विल बी एप्लीकेबल. नाउ सपोज अगर ये सब हो ही ना, हो ही ना मीन्स कि सपोज आपने गुड्स इंश्योर ही ना करवाए, देन इट्स वेरी इजी एंट्री, देन ओनली वन एंट्री यू विल पास. लॉस बाय फायर अकाउंट डेबिटेड टू परचेजेस 10,000 एंड इन दिस केस दिस होल लॉस विल बी ट्रांसफर्ड टू प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट डेबिटेड टू लॉस बाय फायर. आई होप दिस पॉइंट इज क्लियर. लॉस बाय फायर इज 10,000, गुड्स गोज 10,000. फर्स्ट एंट्री इज सेम, दिस सेकेंड एंट्री विल नॉट बी पास बिकॉज वी हैव नॉट गॉट द गुड्स इंश्योर्ड. And third entry also will not be passed because we are not getting any cash in this case because हमने the goods insure नहीं करवाई. It means that total loss of at least 10,000 will be transferred to profit and loss account. Here only loss of rupees 3,000 has been transferred to profit and loss account because out of 10,000, 7,000 has been paid by the insurance company. So a loss of 7,000 has been recovered, only 3,000 is left. But in this case we have not got the goods insured, so nobody is going to help us. So the entire loss of rupees 10,000 will be transferred to profit and loss account. So I hope this point is clear to everybody. So the chapter journal is over. So now you keep practicing and keep doing. Thank you.